the laparoscopic type C1 radical hysterectomy. In this particular case, the procedure started from the left pelvic lymphadenectomy. The atheliolysis performed to obtain good exposure of the left pelvic area. The left round ligament coagulated and cut. The peritoneal incision prolonged cranially and caudally. The vesico-umbilical artery grasped and pulled medially, so the entrance of the paravesical space is exposed. The paravesical space is dissected up to the pelvic floor. The dissection is carried out along the vesico-hypogastric fascia. Once the levator ani muscle has been achieved, the dissection proceeded caudally towards the bifurcation of the iliac artery. Internal iliac artery and vesico-hypogastric fascia are the medial limits of the dissection at this point.
The ureter encountered medial to the internal iliac artery.
Once the ventral and medial limits of paravesical space are dissected, the dissection shifted laterally and the external iliac vessels are detached from the psoas muscle. Dissection carried out over the fascia of the psoas muscle. Once the paravisceral fat detached from its medial and lateral borders, it can be dissected from external iliac vessels and parietal branches of internal iliac vessels. The genitofemoral nerve left intact. The lymphatic and fatty tissue removed along whole circumference of external iliac vessels. Variable anatomy of parietal branch of internal iliac artery and vein requires the meticulous dissection in presspinous region. Right pelvic lymphadenectomy. Right pelvic lymph nodes are removed in the similar fashion. Development of vesico-vaginal space. The peritoneum of the vesico-vaginal fold is coagulated and cut from left to right round ligaments. The urinary bladder grasped by atraumatic forceps and pulled upwards. The vesico-vaginal space developed by dissection of urinary bladder from the cervix and proximal vagina. up to the level of vesical trigone. The dissection proceeded laterally, and Yabuki Ford spaces are developed. The distal ureters can be visualized at this point. Development of right Latsko space. In the nerve-sparing procedure, the Latsko space has been dissected into the limited extent to avoid the damage of pelvic plexus. The lymphatics, located medially to the internal iliac artery, are removed. Isolation of the right vesico-umbilical artery. The vesico-umbilical artery is dissected from the ventral parametrium, and the superficial vesical artery is coagulated and cut. Management of right lateral parametrium. The uterine artery is coagulated and cut close to the internal iliac artery. Then, the superficial uterine vein is coagulated and cut as well. Development of right Okabayashi space. In contrast to Latsko space, the Okabayashi space has been developed quite excessively, so as the mesoureter and the fibers of hypogastric nerve are dissected away from the dorsal parametrium. dissection and sacrification of right deep uterine vein. The right deep uterine vein is isolated, coagulated, and cut medial to the ureter to avoid the mechanical or thermal damage of pelvic plexus. One can appreciate the spired branches of pelvic plexus here. Ureter unroofing and management of ventral parametrium on the right side. The ureteral branch of the uterine artery is coagulated and cut so as the ureteric canal can be safely entered. Then, the superficial layer of vesica uterine ligament is gradually cut just close to the bladder wall. Once the vesico-uterine ligament is cut, the distal ureter can be easily lateralized, and the medial portion of deep layer of vesico-uterine ligament is exposed. The bladder branch of pelvic splanchnic nerve can be visualized. Isolation of left vesica umbilical artery. The left vesica umbilical artery is detached from ventral parametrium, and the left superior vesical artery is coagulated and cut. Management of left lateral parametrium. The left uterine artery and the superficial uterine vein are coagulated and cut. Development of left Okabayashi space. Left Okabayashi space is developed and the mesoureter and the hypogastric nerve are pushed laterally. Ureter unroofing and management of ventral parametrium on the left side. The cut end of uterine vessels is grasped and pulled laterally. The superficial layer of vesicouterine ligament is cut close to the bladder wall. The course of the ureter is checked. At the same time, the ureter is dissected from the surrounding tissue. The attention is paid to keep the ureteral sheath intact, so as minimizing the distal ureter devascularization. The ureter dissected up to its entry into the urinary bladder.
Management of dorsal parameter. Since the hypogastric nerves are completely detached and lateralized, nothing restricts the radicality of posterior parametrial resection in terms of nerve sparing procedure. The resection starts from rectosigmoid colon and proceeds towards the vagina. The key point of this part of the procedure is to find the embryological plane between the mesorectum and dorsal parametrium. The harmonic ace is utilized here. Once both dorsal parametria are dissected off the mesorectal envelope and lateralized, the rectum is grasped by atraumatic forceps and pulled cranially. Due to this maneuver, the rectovaginal plane can be easily identified, so as the rectum is safely dissected off the dorsal vagina. Now, the dorsal parametria can be radically resected close to the rectum. Management of paraculpia. The paraculpia, together with medial vascular portion of deep layer of vesicocervical ligament, are resected by means of harmonic ace.
colpotomy. The uterus with the proximal vagina is excised in standard fashion. Ceramic colpotomizer of Clermont-Ferrand uterine manipulator facilitates this part of the procedure, so the length of excised vagina can be adjusted as desired. Dissection of common iliac and subaortic lymph nodes. The common iliac and subaortic lymph nodes are dissected at the end of the procedure. Better visualization of this region obtained by moving the scope from standard umbilical port to supraumbilical port. The peritoneal incision prolonged cranially up to the superior mesenteric artery. The both right and left ureters are the lateral landmarks of lymphadenectomy. Peritoneal suspension. The edges of dissected peritoneum are suspended up by means of bursa needle, so as the area of lymphadenectomy is fully exposed. it is safe to start a dissection over the common iliac arteries. The superior hypogastric plexus has been isolated and sparred. The fatty and lymphatic tissue in the area of aortic bifurcation is dissected away without damaging of superior hypogastric plexus and proximal hypogastric nerves. Then, the common iliac, proximal para-aortic and paracaval lymph nodes are dissected. vaginal closure. The vaginal cuff, closed by means of two figure of eight, two all-absorbable intracorporeal sutures. The final view. Final view demonstrates the paravisceral space free of lymphatic and fatty tissue. The obturator nerve, parietal branch of internal iliac vessels, the ventral part of sciatic nerve, intrapelvic ischial spine, and sacrospinous ligament. The specimen. On this picture, one can see the resected proximal vagina, the dorsal parametria, and ventrolateral parametria in one block.